Is there a relationship between monthly sales data, outdoor temperature, and discounts that store offers during the year? In this tutorial, we're going to establish the dependencies between those parameters and also build combo graph in Microsoft Excel with multiple line charts and bar graph that clearly shows this dependency.
Hi there, this is Vadim Michalenko from Stunning Professional Presentations, where we teach you how to use different tools to create awesome business presentations.
Stunning Professional Presentations.
Let's first take a look at the final version of the document to see how it might be relevant to what you're trying to accomplish.
Let's first look at the final version of this tutorial. For the source data, we'll use a four-column Microsoft Excel table. First column will show months, in the second column will show sales, then we'll show outdoor temperature, average outdoor temperature for the region, and then we'll show a discount policy that store has established. This is the imaginary store in Midwestern region of United States. In our first tutorial, we've established the dependency between sales and outdoor temperature, and we found out that people shop less during the colder weather. But this dependency did not explain everything, and now we're trying to establish and show on the graph dependency between the sales, temperature, and also discount that store offered during the year. And to accomplish this, we're gonna build Microsoft Excel combo chart with multiple line graphs on it. In this graph, sales will be represented by the bar chart, and temperature and discounts will be represented by the line graphs. Combo graph in Excel is very useful when you have data that varies widely in the data ranges, which is exactly the case for us because sales are in the thousands and temperature and discounts are in the single and double digits. In this case, we can represent sales as the bar graph in Microsoft Excel, and we can represent temperature as a separate line graph and connect it to secondary axis. And we can also connect discount to the secondary axis in Excel because temperature and discount are very similar in their data ranges, but at the same times vary widely from the sales data.
I wanted to mention that this video is the part of the multi-video series where we teach you how to take the document and make it ready for the business presentation, which could be shared with the business leaders. So make sure to look in the description of this video to find the links to the remaining parts of this tutorial.
We start with Microsoft Excel data, then create chart with secondary axis in Excel, then add 3D effects to the chart. Then in the second tutorial, we create an additional line graph on a secondary axis chart. And then in the last tutorial, we take created chart into PowerPoint and create animations for professional presentation. Links to all the tutorials and downloads are available in the description of the video. Make sure to check them out. And all the best on your project. So let's go ahead and start with our featured tutorial. First, let's take a look at the source data. Our source data consists of four columns in Microsoft Excel spreadsheet. We have all the data that we need to start creating of the combo chart in Microsoft Excel. Our combo chart will consist of three charts: bar chart, which would represent monthly sales, line chart, which would display average outdoor temperature, and then another line chart, which would represent discounts. Let's verify that we have everything we need to generate the chart. In the table, we have monthly sales data, average outdoor temperature, and average monthly discounts, and they are represented for the entire year. And this is exactly what we need. Also, both average outdoor temperature and average monthly discounts are in the same data range, single and double digits, which could be proportionally reflected in the graph. So now let's go ahead and create the graph. To create combo graph, let's click on the Insert tab in the ribbon, and then click Insert Combo Chart. And we will pick Clustered Column Chart with Line on Secondary Axis. As you can see, the chart looks very plain. So we're gonna do some formatting, change the title, and also add some 3D effects so it looks professional. As a first step, let's change the title of the chart. You can use the title of this tutorial, for example. Let's stick with the functional title, correlation between monthly sales, outdoor temperature, and discounts. As you can see, our final chart also is not accurately representing temperature and discounts. This is because temperature and sales are in the same bar chart, and because they are in such a substantially different data ranges, temperature data is not visible. As a next step, let's move temperature into the second axis in Microsoft Excel, and also from the bar chart, we'll make it a line chart. To do that, do a right mouse click on the chart and select Change Chart Type. And here, for the temperature, select the line chart and also connect it to secondary axis. Now you see that the chart looks correct, but we still need to do formatting and add some 3D effects to make it look professional.
Are you enjoying this episode? Make sure to subscribe so you're not missing the next one, and tell your friends about it so they will learn more skills in the area. Now let's continue and have more fun.
First, let's add 3D effects to the bar chart, which represents sales. To do that, let's select the bar chart on the graph and change the values in the 3D format section for top bevel and also material. As a next step, let's change the temperature graph. We're going to change the thickness of the line chart. Add a line marker. Let's also make chart a little bit bigger on the screen, so it's easier to select. And make markers 3D. And now we're going to do the same for the discounts graph. We're going to select the line chart, which represents discounts. We're going to change the line thickness. We're also going to add markers. And we're going to make markers look 3D. This is how final version of the chart looks like. We've accomplished exactly what we wanted. Let's recap. First, we've looked at the source data in Microsoft Excel to see if we can create the chart that we want. As a next step, we added the combo graph in Microsoft Excel. Then we changed the formatting for the graph, and we added a title. We also added some 3D effects to the bar chart, and we also added 3D effect to the line graphs. For line graphs, we've increased the thickness of the line and added the markers. And as a last step, we changed markers to look 3D. Now let's see if we can answer the business question. What does best explain variance in monthly sales for hardware store in Midwestern region of the United States? Can both changes in outdoor temperature and changes in promotional discounts offered by the store explain variation? Sales volume variation can be explained by multiple variants: outdoor temperature and discounts offered by the store. Fewer people shop during the winter month, but changes in outdoor temperature don't explain all sales volume variation throughout the year. During warmer weather, people buy more than during the winter month. But we also learn that volume varies based on the discounts stores offer during the warmer months' climates. Which makes sense because people buy more the more discounted prices they see at the store. That means that there is a correlation between the percentage of the discounts and sales volume. The higher the discounts, the higher the monthly sales numbers. We can see this difference between June and July, and also August and September. In June, the sale volume is low because lower discounts are offered in the store. And in July, probably because of the 4th of July holiday, with higher discounts offered, there is a higher sales volume. Very similar pattern is for August versus September. In August, there is no discounts offered by the store. But in September, there is a high discount, probably because of the Labor Day holiday. And that explains higher volumes in July and September versus month of June and August.
Just a quick reminder that this video is a part of the multi-video series where we teach you how to take the data, analyze it, format it, and prepare for the business presentation. This presentation could later be shared with the business leaders. So make sure to look in the description of the video to find the remaining pieces of the puzzle and look at the entire video series to accomplish your goals. Have you enjoyed this episode? Make sure to subscribe so you will not miss the next one, and tell your friends about it. Thanks for watching. Hope you've learned something and enjoyed this video. If you can, please share this information with somebody who might be working on the presentation right now and will benefit from this tutorial. Also, please share your comments and thoughts in the comment sections down below. I really review all of them and respond if opportunity permits, and of course if I know the answer. Also, if you like this video, please click that like button right there. This really helps me with my rankings. You can find links and downloads in the description section of this video. There are a lot of helpful links and a lot of other helpful information you will benefit from.
Make sure to check out my other relevant videos and subscribe to my YouTube channel. We have a lot of great stuff planned in the pipeline, and I don't want you to miss any of it. And if you'd like to get notified about all the new stuff that are coming out, make sure to subscribe to my email list as well. All links are here on the screen. Make sure to click to stay in touch. Thanks again for watching.